Hi, I am Alexandra Barker. Whenever you cannot find an estimate with our pre-tabulated data products, working with microdata can be a great alternative because you can create your own tabulations from individual records. I asked my colleague Rex to show us how to access microdata, select variables and geographies, and put it all together in a table. You'll be amazed.
Hi, I'm Rex. If you ever found that a data estimate you need isn't published, or you need more detailed estimates than the pre-tabulated tables provide, you may want to consider using microdata access. This allows you to pick and choose your own variables and create custom estimates. In this data jam, I'll walk you through an example of using microdata access. Let's say I need to know the number of individuals ages 18 to 45 in Oregon with a disability. As we can see, table B18101 in data.census.gov uses age groupings of 18 to 34 years and 35 to 64 years that won't allow me to determine this number. So this is the perfect example of when to use microdata access. Microdata access can be found at data.census.gov/mdat. Currently, public use data from the American Community Survey and a current population survey can be found here. For this example, we'll choose the ACS 1-year estimates. The years of data that are available differ depending on the data set you choose. The ACS 1-year estimates are currently available going back to 2004. We'll keep the vintage as 2018 for this example. Click Next. This screen is where you'll select your variables. For this example, we want to look at both the age and disability status variables. The age variable AGEP happens to be the quickest to locate because it appears first. So I'm going to check the box next to it. Notice that when I check it, it gives me a message letting me know that I'll need to create a recode in order to place this variable in a certain way in my table. We'll come back to this in a minute. For now, to find a disability status variable, I'm going to enter the word disability into the label box. This brings up three variables. It looks like the second one, DIS, may be the one I want. So I'll confirm this by checking details. This recode includes have a disability or does not have a disability. So yes, this is the one I want. So I'm going to check the box next to it. You can see that I have two variables in my data card. Now, I'm going to navigate to the Select Geographies tab. I want Oregon. So I'm going to select State and Oregon. I can see the chip showing that it was added at the bottom of the screen. Now, I'm going to move to Data Card tab. This is where I'll have to create the age recode in order to get data for the 18 to 45 year olds. I'm going to hit the Create Custom Group button and change the group label to age 18 to 45. Then I'm going to check the box next to 1 to 99 years and change the values to 18 and 45 and hit the Save Group button. Now, we have two age groupings, one for the age 18 to 45 year olds that I need and another called Not Elsewhere Classified that includes the remainder of the population. I'm going to change the name of this groups by clicking on the Add a Group button. Then I'm going to change the group label to under age 18 and check the box for between 1 and 17 and under 1 year. Then I'll hit Save Group. When it returns to the list of age recodes, I still have one not elsewhere classified group, so I'm going to click Add a Group. Change the group label to over age 45. Check the box next to between 46 and 99 and hit Save Group. Now, I have all three groups clearly labeled. Next, I'm going to go to the Table Layout tab. Right now, I don't have my age recode included in the table. So I'm going to click on AGEP_RC1 and drag it to the rows under Selected Geographies. As you can see, the table updates automatically to reflect where I've moved the variables. You can move the variables around to see alternate layouts of the table. The only thing I need to do is change the values in the table cells from average of age to count. I think this looks good, so I'm going to hit the View Table button in the lower corner. Now, we have the data populated in the table. There are 140,456 people ages 18 to 45 with a disability in Oregon. Notice that the weighting has automatically been applied to the variables. You can also have the option on the screen to rearrange your variables in the table, change the vintage, or change the data set. If I select download/share button at the top, I can download a table. To do this, I'm going to check the box next to Download Table View and hit the Download button. This creates a CSV file that I can open in Excel. I hope this is helpful. Thank you.
Thank you, Rex. This was very useful. And for all of you, give it a try, check out Microdata, create your own tabulation. And if you need more videos like this, visit census.gov/academy and subscribe. Thank you.